Hi, my name is Alex, and welcome to the next episode in our WordPress mini-series. Since we went over how to make static pages in the last video, it only makes sense that we will now show you how to make a dynamic page. Dynamic pages are perfect for blogging or other websites that are constantly updating some of their pages. The great thing about dynamic pages is that updates are built into the structure of the page, so content automatically shows up. It doesn't have to be entered manually. See? It's never as hard or as much work as it seems. Most of the time. In order to create a dynamic page, we need to create a new page so that we have somewhere to put the content. Go to your dashboard and then go to Pages and click Add New. Let's go ahead and name it Updates and Information. Now, click Publish. Alright, so since we are making a dynamic page, that means content will be updated quite often. So we are making a blog type page. We have to tell WordPress that we want this page to be a blog page, so all of the updates go to this page. Click on Settings, then click on Reading. Once again, this tells the website how to arrange the site. We are going to tell the site that the page is going to be the blog page, so that it puts all the posts on this page automatically. Now let's click Save Changes, and flip over to the Browser tab where our website preview is. Refresh, and voila! You'll see that there's a standard post here that automatically shows up when you create a blog page. So we'll show you how to make your own post. You're going to go to Dashboard, and then to Posts. Here you will see all the content that you've posted. First, we should delete the default post. Now we want to make a blog post, so we click Add New on the top left. Now let's add in some useful posts. I'll fast forward through it, since you'll be entering your own content here. To liven up this post, we're going to add a picture. Click Add Media, and then we go find the image and select it. Then click Insert into Post. Now click Publish, and go to the tab and let's check this out. Wow, that actually looks good. Sweet success. There's always room for improvement though. For instance, this sidebar is not up to our standards. In fact, it's not even close. So to remove it, we go over to the dashboard, then to Appearance, and then Widgets. Widgets are cool little things that you click and drag onto your page if you want. Since we want them gone, all we have to do is click and drag them away. Let's add a custom menu. Before we add the custom menu widget, we need to go to the Menu section. Here we'll add some custom links. We'll create a new menu and type in a name for it. We'll call it Useful HostPapa Links. Next, we'll type in our URL and give it an appropriate label. Then click Add to Menu. I'll create a few more just to fill up the last little bit. Click Save Menu and return to the Widgets section. Now we'll click and drag the custom menu widget to our list under Sidebar Blog. We'll call it Useful HostPapa Links and click on Save Changes. Let's check to make sure the changes have been applied. Huzzah! Our new links and widgets are looking great. Now that you know how to create both static and dynamic pages, we're nearly done. In the next video, we'll show you how to add a photo to your gallery site.